After watching one of our videos, a viewer by the name of Aaron Munoz, Z, left this comment, and Aaron writes, I'm observing a pattern here. Many successful directors did whatever they could to make their first low-budget feature. Short films seem to be a waste of time in terms of launching a career. What's your response to Aaron?
I actually completely agree with that statement. My personal feeling is like short films are kind of dead in the water nowadays. Feature films nowadays, your low budget features, because you could do them on such low budgets and cameras are so accessible nowadays. Your low budget features are what your short films and music videos were 20 years ago. Now you don't hear about people doing a short or like a music video and getting like a huge budget film. But if you're doing your low budget features on the sentiment that those are to build up to a big budget feature, that's really kind of what it is nowadays. They look at what you've done, you get a movie that was a festival darling, and that gets you a bigger project.
So make it your film school, sort of, to make short films and
well,
get
yeah,
your name out there.
I think that there's so much room to live and grow in this, so that, you know, the films you make should definitely be your learning experience. I remember when I did my first film, My Pure Joy, it was a complete learning experience because I had a $7,000 budget. I was 18 years old. Nobody wanted to work with me, so I had to do every single job on the film. I was craft services. I held the boom. I did lighting. I edited it. I literally, like, every job imaginable I did on that film. And I think that's what really helped me grow as a filmmaker. It was my film school. I had to do everything. I was a 3-person crew on that. It was me, a makeup artist that I helped doing special effects with, and a DP who owned the camera. And so that was it. And we made a movie on a $7,000 budget. The one thing we were able to get very easily was actors to work for free. because everybody wants to act. But after that, it was, you know, it was a learning curve. And I learned so much from that film that when I look back on it, I'm like, I should have never, you know, released this. But miraculously, it got onto the bestsellers list on Amazon. We were ranked number 32 in horror for a month and a half. And I put a lot of, you know, PR and marketing behind it. I sat there for days and days, because before I did that, I did, you know, PR and marketing when I was a kid for a bunch of DJs, like, you know, big electronic music artists that were playing, you know, around the world. And I used to throw raves, so I knew how to, you know, market stuff. So I pushed the film a bunch, and it sold well. And so I think ultimately what's important for a filmmaker is to learn from every single project they do. Always try to raise the budget. Always try to tell a good story. Don't be so concerned about everything being so perfect on your first one, because as long as you get the first one done, you can always do the next one. I mean, and the most important thing for me, I think, was learning how important it is to promote your project, because you have to go out there and really hustle the project, because people won't just find out about it through osmosis. You have to expose people to something 3 times before they actually become familiar with it. So you have to literally keep promoting it. So when they go and they're scrolling down on like something like Dread Central and they see an article about your movie, they'll be like, oh, that looks interesting. And then they're on Bloody Disgusting and they see an article about your movie and they're like, oh yeah, that looks interesting. And then they're on, like, you know, More Horror and they see an article about your movie. They're like, okay, I'm going to check this movie out. It seems like everybody's talking about it. And that's what you have to do, or else people will just be like, well, what's that? And also you have to time the press correctly, because if it's not around the right time that the movie's coming out, they'll get familiar with it and then totally forget that it exists by the time it comes out. So both things are important. But as far as the learning from your short films, I think short films are a great place to learn and grow when you're doing short form and harnessing your abilities, but they're not going to get you that big budget feature. They're not going to get you, you know, a feature. What you need to do is maybe hone your craft in the short films however you want, and just play. I was making short films since I was, you know, 6 years old. And, you know, I've I did tons of short films. I used to turn in short films. My teachers hated me in middle school and high school. Instead of doing book reports, I would turn in a short film on why I didn't want to do the book report. So, you know, always make short films and learn and grow from that, but really harness your abilities from your features and use those features as stepping stones for the next feature. And as long as you're going up in some way, be it budget or cast or just making a better movie on each go round, you're doing great. Because at the end of the day, if you're not learning and you're improving and you're not improving, then it's time to quit. Because if you haven't learned something from what you do each time, then you have nothing left to learn, and everybody has something left to learn. So if you think you don't, stop doing it.